Find the domain and range shown in the graph. Let's talk about domain first. Domain is set of all the inputs, which are shown on the horizontal axis here. In this case, we have x. And the inputs, the least value seems to be at negative 5 right here. And the greatest x value seems to be at 6 right here. And notice we have a continuous line. Continuous line means that all real numbers are represented here between negative 5 and positive 6. So, the way we put the domain, squiggle bracket first. Okay, now the domain is going to be created using set builder notation. And set builder notation is good because you can use it to represent a lot of numbers and you can write it in a concise way. Now, there's an infinite number of real numbers between negative 5 and positive 6. We can't list all those numbers, so we use set builder to build the set of numbers in that domain. So we start off with x because that's the input variable, and then we use this funky e symbol, it's a Greek letter, it's lowercase epsilon, and then we use capital R to represent the real numbers. So we have x is an element of the real numbers, or another way to read this is x is in the real numbers. So we're defining the set of numbers that the x is in, such that we use a vertical bar or we can use a colon, and then we need to specifically say the values of real numbers for x. And we say the lowest value is negative 5, greatest value is positive 6. So we have x is greater than or equal to negative 5, less than or equal to 6. Close the squiggle bracket. There's the domain in set builder notation. Let me read the whole thing to you. The domain is x is an element of the real numbers such that, the vertical bar, x is greater than or equal to negative 5, less than or equal to positive 6. And that's what the x values are on this graph. Now let's talk about the range. Squiggle bracket again. Now the lowest value, or the least value I should say, for y is right here at negative 1. And the greatest value is at positive 3. So we're going to say y, because y is the output variable shown here, is an element of the real numbers. The same reasoning, you have line segments here, and those are continuous, which means all real numbers are represented. So y is an element of the real numbers such that, now y has to be greater than or equal to the least value of negative 1, and then y, and then 3, we said, was the greatest number. Close squiggle brackets. Okay, let's take a look at this. The range, y is an element of the real numbers such that y is greater than or equal to negative 1 and less than or equal to 3. And that defines all the y values shown in the graph. That's the range. Okay, so there's how you would use set builder notation, reading a graph, to define the domain and range.